just motion and shine. Well, okay, we're just gonna put that back. It's cute though, right?
Granny doily, come on. This screams me in the shirt.
Most people don't know this. When they woke up today, they actually did drag.
Is there a thing of over-accessorizing? It's gorgeous. Oh, that's great too.
Presentation is an opportunity to go ham.
History. How we choose to dress says a lot about who we are. What society considers feminine and masculine in clothing has changed a lot throughout the eras. During the reign of King Louis XV in 18th century France, pink was a masculine color associated with ideas of novelty, elegance, and aristocratic splendor. U.S. President Franklin Delano Roosevelt wore dresses as a child in the 1880s, an outfit that was considered gender neutral at the time. At the end of the day, or century, clothing and style are fluid, just like us.
So I've coined the term granny chic for my style.
When my clothing is doing the thing that I want it to do, I feel like I'm hosting the ultimate party. Wait, this one? Okay, wait. Being seen and also seeing other people, like I feel like there's more of a sharing that happens with the people that I interact with.
So I work in national policy. They all wear blue and gray suits. Ew. If you go out with me, people look. I don't know if they're looking because they love my clothes or if because I'm sitting on 26-inch trims. Either way, it's sort of my armor to feel my complete self, regardless of their perception.
Yuha Hamasaki is the superhero that I've created for myself. And when I dress up, I feel brave, I feel confident, I feel happy. Honestly, drag has saved my life.
I'm first generation Latin, Latina, so homophobia is huge in the Latin community, unfortunately, and also like being Catholic and all that stuff. I think to survive, as a lot of queer people do, we try to fit in as best as we can.
I didn't really have, you know, an accepting family growing up. I mean, they were loving, they were caring, but they were still traditional Chinese parents. So I have to be very conservative, very traditional, you know, the jeans, the t-shirt, the hoodie, all that stuff.
I mean, the first time I put on a dress, I was with a friend. He told me to go to the dressing room, and I like couldn't. I like opened the door and was like, do you see my dress? He was like, you look great. I couldn't embody it in that moment. Like I was still in the dressing room, like with the door open, just like, look quick, I'm gonna close the door. That was maybe the multi-year long process of me trying on more things, having more friends that say, you look great.
When I discovered what being gay was, I thought that there was a new set of rules that you have to follow, that you have to wear skinny jeans, tight t-shirts, tight pants. I never really fit into any one of them. I've realized that I can just be myself.
Once I accepted my queerness, I then started to explore masculinity a bit. Baggier clothing, like being more butch, I guess. I wanted to be visibly queer and I wanted the world to see that so that I could feel it as well.
I grew up in foster care. So I was taken away from my family at the age of 6. I formed my disability identity quickly because I had to navigate the world in that way. And so I had 6 different families that I grew up with, white, cis families. So coming out, I originally came out at 14. And the first thing they said to me is, you can't be gay. And so I moved out at 17 and started on this journey of trying to love myself and pushing through other people's barriers.
I think my style evolved from conforming and being this like all-American girl to then exploring my queerness and my identity through masculinity and expressing myself in that way. And that helped me to get to where I am today with my like hyper-femme kind of maybe even mocking femininity and playing into drag a little bit.
I'm Latinx. I'm disabled. I really didn't want to be queer as well. I didn't want to be LGBTQ. And so coming out at 17, I had no choice. Like the universe basically said, I made you this unicorn. You're gonna have to deal with it and deal with it quick. I would say you are loved. You are who you're supposed to be. And even though you don't love yourself now, you're gonna find your tribe.
It's like, you're a person, you're not a Pinterest board. Like, you know, dress the way you want.
Start with one thing. One scarf, one hat, one shoe, and work your way up. It doesn't have to happen overnight, and it could be ever evolving. You know, I hope I'm gonna be some sassy 70-year-old wearing leather pants and like beautiful scarves.
You're already on the path. You're already doing it. So just keep going.